Good evening, I'm Chevy Chase, and you're not.
Good evening, I'm Jane Curtin. Our top story tonight.
I'm Kevin Nealon, and that's news to me.
The Weekend Update, I'm Jimmy Fallon.
I'm Tina Fey. Good night, and have a pleasant tomorrow.
The Weekend Update, I'm Seth Meyers.
I'm Amy Poehler.
Boy, they make it look easy, don't they? There's a look at Saturday Night Live's trademark Weekend Update newscast through the years. SNL kicked off its 39th season this weekend. 39th. Welcoming cast member Cecily Strong to the anchor desk. She'll continue co-hosting alongside Seth Meyers, part of the show's transition as Meyers prepares to move over to late night on NBC, beginning early next year. Tina Fey was on hand last night to give her some tips.
You're going to be great. Would you mind if I just gave you a couple little pieces of advice, though?
I would love it.
Okay, great. Here's what it is. Okay. You keep your head down, you do your time. On the first day, you go up to the biggest guy in the yard and punch him in the face. See, don't mess with Texas. Keep your feet on the ground. Keep reaching for the stars. Believe in your nightmares. You see this man here? This man don't own you. You do you. You in charge.
Well, let's see if our guests are laughing. Back with us now, James Poniewozik and Maureen Ryan. James, might she be the next Tina Fey or the next Amy Poehler?
Well, when you look at the lineup of people who have been on Weekend Update, you sort of have to think, well, how could she not be? Like, it's been such an effective launching platform. You either end up with a sitcom or hosting a late night show for Lorne Michaels on NBC. So, you know, it's a tremendous platform. You know, I think the challenge with Cecily Strong is that she's somebody who, you know, in her short term on SNL has been really, really good at doing characters. And on Weekend Update, you don't do a character so much as you're developing a persona. And, you know, I think that she and the writers are still trying to figure out how to translate her character work, like, you know, girl that you wish you hadn't started a conversation with at a party, into a persona for Weekend Update. And I think, you know, I just think that's going to take a bit of a while. It's sort of a different journey for her than it was for, say, Tina Fey, who, like the show had a little bit of fun with last night, wasn't known for doing a ton of characters before she started Weekend Update. She had been a writer and then stepped into that. So, I think it's sort of using a bit of a different comedic muscle, and that's going to take a little while.
Let's take a look at a clip from last night from the actual fake newscast.
In an interview this week, Iran's new president Hassan Rouhani distanced himself from his predecessor Mahmoud Ahmadinejad and acknowledged that the Holocaust was real, which I believe is the very definition of the least you could do.
Now, like it or not, Maureen, some people get real news from these fake newscasts, don't they?
Yeah, I think that people are always looking for that spin on the news and that comedic persona to come at it from a different perspective. And I agree with James. I think that Cecily Strong made a big impression last year. She had a few characters that kind of, you know, took off. I wish the girl you wish you hadn't talked to at the party was coming back. I wish there's a way that they could have her on Update. But I think she's really, to my mind, in the Amy Poehler tradition and really ultimately could be a very key player going forward. We'll have to see. But Amy Poehler was like Cecily Strong. You could pretty much throw her into any kind of sketch, and she would either elevate it, even make it a little bit better than it was. So she's got that ability. I do wonder if they're going to miss that in the regular rotation of sketches if she's taken up a lot with Weekend Update. Because after the middle of the season, allegedly, there's a possibility that Seth Meyers will be gone to prep for his new show. I mean, I'm sure they'd love him to stick around the whole season. So this is an enormous transition year in a lot of ways, with a lot of new cast members and a lot of people who have left in the last year or two. So Cecily Strong, I think, has the potential to be the next sort of Amy Poehler performer update hybrid. But, I wish her every success because she's done well so far, I think. I think she's acquitted herself admirably, put it that way.
1 week down, many to go. Well, Maureen Ryan, James Poniewozik, thanks for joining us.